out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole. I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the failed clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is blooded but unbound. Beyond this place of wrath and tears, looms but the horrors of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. All things are connected. You may think that a concept or character from one television show or movie has nothing to do with a different television show or movie, but you would be wrong. It is all part of a shared interconnected cinematic universe in which deep occult metaphysical principles are buried. Let us consider opposing dualities. Day and night. Fire and ice. Life and death. These polar opposites are two sides of the same continuum. In the movie Star Wars, the Force is the name given to the vital energy which animates all living beings. In the African Congo, this vital energy is called Nzambi, which is the origin of the word zombie from the voodoo culture of Haiti. Zombies are created by using the Force to give life to the dead. Historically, this was called necromancy. This ability could also be used to bring to life inanimate objects, like talismans, voodoo dolls, and statues. In the movie Star Wars, one of these Force users was named Darth Maul, who was one of the Knight Brothers from the planet Dathomir. On the TV show Game of Thrones, the necromancer, who harnesses the Force to animate the White Walker army of the dead, is called the Night King. There is no coincidence. These two characters represent the same thing, have similar appearances and similar names as the Night Brother and the Night King. They represent the unstoppable, inevitable, insurmountable force we call death. Some say the world will end in fire. Some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction ice is also great and would suffice.